What went through your mind?
They got caught. Thank God. Because we were tired of it. It was in and out all night long.
Brand new details about that big meth bust on the Treasure Coast. Deputies say it's the largest ever in the Vero Beach area. Good evening. Thanks for staying with us. I'm Todd McDermott.
And I'm Tiffany Kenny. Let's get straight to Angela Rozier. She is live in Vero Beach. Angela.
Well, Tiffany, you know, the people who live in this neighborhood, they're concerned about the children who used to live here. You can see their toys still here in the yard. But we're told by officials they're in DCF custody right now, but the adults, well, they're in jail. From the outside, this home on 22nd Avenue in Vero Beach looks peaceful. But one neighbor tells us that's not the case at all.
One night, I was sitting here like 11 o'clock. I was telling her this big boom.
A spokesman with the Indian River County Sheriff's Office tells us the people living inside this house were operating a meth lab. And he says, judging from the amount of equipment inside, it's the largest they've ever seen in this area.
It was just a number of separate setups that were going on inside the house at the same time.
That is what just scares the heck out of me, really.
Vicki Gould is the president of the Osceola Park Neighborhood Association. She's lived here since 1994.
Shocking, but in some ways, I'm not really surprised. That house has been sketchy for a long, long time.
Diane Fay lives across the street. She was at home when the detective showed up Thursday morning.
I saw the people living sitting in that house, sitting on the ground, cut.
What went through your mind?
They got caught. Thank God. Because we were tired of it. It was in and out all night long.
Officials say an anonymous caller tipped them off about the house. They said the detectives from the county's multi-agency criminal enforcement unit and the DEA conducted a month-long investigation. A search warrant was issued Thursday morning. Four people were taken into custody, and a hazmat team removed containers loaded with toxic materials.
The residuals that are left in the house will likely need to be cleaned extensively before it can be lived in, if it can ever be lived in again. And that's a possibility that it might not. It may not ever be able to be occupied again.
What did you think when you found out?
I was happy, honestly.
Yep, a lot of people happy to see that they're no longer here. Again, officials tell us that the people who were arrested here today were also users. They are due in court Friday. Reporting live in Vero Beach, Angela Rozier, WPBF 25 News.